Have you ever wondered why so many agents fail? What's up, guys? Ricky Carruth. Welcome back. Today we're going to break down why so many real estate agents fail. And before I get started, if you're getting any value out of me on my Instagram or any other social media posts, please click subscribe and hit the bell right now for YouTube so you can get notified every time I post new videos. 87% of real estate agents end up failing and having to get out of the business and going back to their 9-to-5 job. My goal with Zero to Diamond is to reduce the failure rate in the real estate industry by spreading my philosophy across the entire industry. Relationships over transactions, losing deals gives you an opportunity, outwork every single real estate agent in your market. Conversation is the key to all closings. And every single fear that you have about markets crashing, losing deals, if you'll survive, every single fear that you have about the business is actually an opportunity if you look at it the right way. Real estate is actually a win-win scenario. There's no way to lose unless you just quit or you continue doing the same things over and over and over again that don't work and you stay busy being non-productive. That's a trap new agents get into. They're busy, they think that they're doing the right things, but they're busy doing the things that don't produce results. I think the biggest reason why real estate agents fail is because real estate is A, such a lag business. What you do today may not pay you for a month, 2 months, 6 months, a year, 5 years, or even 10 years. B, real estate has such a sharp learning curve. It takes so long to really get it and to understand the ins and outs of everything you need to know to really crush it in real estate and create consistent sales. So the fact that real estate is such a lag business and it takes so long to learn, most people get caught up in never getting to the paycheck before they learn how to actually create a paycheck, and before then, all kinds of bills are still coming in that they have to pay and they can't survive. They have to go back to their 9-to-5 job so that they can pay their bills. Another problem is that real estate is already super tough, as in it's a lag business and a sharp learning curve, but on top of that, we have so many distractions in today's market. We have so many people and so many companies trying to tell us what we need to be doing to make money in real estate. So it makes it really tough for new agents to cipher through the good and the bad information to find what really actually works. At the end of the day, I believe everything works. I think every avenue of business in real estate works. If you work it, if it works for you, you have to try everything and figure out what's most efficient for you and what produces results for you. Everybody's different. Understanding this and being able to stop doing something that's not working that great and going all in on something that is working is a huge skill. Successful real estate agents are a complete package. They're really good at figuring out what's efficient. They're hard workers. They're good with people. They're good with numbers. They're a complete package. And I think that's the it factor. You know, when agents come into the market, I'll look at somebody and say, I think that guy or girl's really gonna be successful, and they come in and in a year, they're not even in the business anymore. Or someone will come in who I don't think is gonna be successful at all and has no personality, and I'm thinking, this isn't gonna last very long, and then all of a sudden, boom, they're a multi-million dollar producer in their first year. So there's an it factor that is really hard to spot. You never know who's gonna be successful and who isn't. You really just have to get in there, put all the pieces together for yourself, and just take action. I think at the end of the day, there's really no wrong answer on what to do, how to do it, all that stuff. I think you just need to go do it and find out for yourself what's working, what's not working, and make adjustments along the way. I think a big part of long-term success is adapting and figuring out what works and what doesn't work and trying everything and becoming as efficient as you can. A big thing for new agents is losing deals. They take it so hard when they're going after a listing and that seller chooses a different agent to list the property and they thought they had it in the bag. This is really hard on new agents, and I really want to drill in your head that losing deals is actually a great opportunity. A, you learn something, and you know next time exactly how to handle that situation a little better. B, you get all the future time back that you don't have to spend on that deal anymore, that you can take this new knowledge you learned and this new future time you have back and go get 5 more deals. I also think mainstream training is really hindering agents from creating those lifelong relationships that they need. by teaching agents to go after the deal and find out who else the prospect knows that might want to buy or sell, or handling objections, or trying to get the person to just sign the line. I think the majority of the population does not want to deal with a high-pressure agent. They would rather deal with an agent who treats them like family and comes to them from a place of, how can I help you now and the rest of your life, and actually puts in the work and proves it to the client that they are dependable, they are hardworking, they are professional, and they're here to stay. So just to recap, most real estate agents fail because real estate is such a lag business, it's such a steep learning curve. You have so many distractions pulling you in so many different directions. Mainstream training is teaching you how to go after the deal, not the relationships. And everybody's worried about losing deals, and they get down on themselves, and then they just turn into a cocoon and they start backpedaling right out of the business. Be confident, work hard, treat your customers right, don't go after the deal, find out what they actually want long and short term, and go out there and help people buy and sell property.